Hey, it's David O'Leary.
And I'm Lynn O'Leary.
And we're here in New York City at the Aging Up Conference at Genworth's Empathy Lab. We're right inside the room where participants are actually going through various stages of aging. So let's go find out what they're experiencing.
I was surprised at how real it felt and the quality of the VR experience. And I really did find myself feeling what it could be like. I think that caregiving is something that we all probably think about with our parents as they're aging. And I think this experience made me think more deeply about it.
So I just went through the Empathy Lab, and what I liked most about it was some of the scientific details, where it talked about how the brain works as you go through your progression of Alzheimer's. For being a visual person, I found it to be very helpful to be able to see what my mom is suffering from.
Being a caregiver is actually multifaceted. I would say in our relationship, caring for my mother-in-law, Lynn's mom, is that I handle the financial side of things. And Lynn, unfortunately, deals with a lot of the emotional side of things. And so as you are a caregiver, you really have to look at it from multiple facets.
I think the hardest thing emotionally is always remembering to stay positive. Everything can be perfect one minute, and the next minute, all the walls come down. I think it is an incredible privilege to be able to take care of someone that you love. It's a huge responsibility that I do not take lightly, clearly. My mom gave me the greatest gift, and it's a huge heart, but yet it's also my largest fault because it tends to swell and break and come back together again. So I think it's made me a better person. It's made me more understanding.
I think the biggest advice that we've learned and something we want to share with others is there is no roadmap. The journey is chaos. There is no easy way to go. There is no consistent path for any family. And the biggest thing that we've had to learn, and we learned it the hard way, was to really look at caregiving through the eyes of the care receiver. Because if you look at it through the eyes that you would have, you would make different decisions that would impact her differently. And so we tend to try to always put ourselves in her position.
It's really, you know, what does your loved one need? And putting them first before anything else. What did you think of it?
It was so realistic, and it gives me a more in-depth understanding of what those suffering with Alzheimer's have to go through. I will walk away with this being the one of the major experiences that I had.
Oh,
I will talk about this.
High five.
High five, you got it.
Recently, my dad suffered a stroke, and it was pretty debilitating, and my stepmother cared for him in our family home. And seeing everything that she had to give up, we're indebted to her. And I think about how I can be preventative about my health, how I can save for myself, but I also am starting to have those conversations with my parents about what their expectations are.
It's very effective. You get to see what the loss would be over time. And in my case, I'm looking for my 97-year-old mother, who's having tremendous hearing problems. She doesn't want a caregiver. She's very determined to be independent. I call her every morning, and we have a little check-in.
Okay.
And she tells me she doesn't need anything, she doesn't want anything, and please leave her alone.
Who were you a caregiver for?
My mother. For a short amount of time, I'm taking care in a different way. I'm taking care of the caregivers.
On behalf of Genworth, we'd like you to do something for you.
What?
So we have a gift card for you to go and do something for you as well.
Bring joy to joy.
Take care of joy.
Thank you so much for coming today and visiting us at the Genworth Empathy Lab. It was really a pleasure and an honor to host you all today. This has been really fun, and I've enjoyed meeting all of these wonderful people. Thank you.
Thank you.